In this video, I'm going to explain very important anatomical connection on backside of knee. I'm going to focus on two muscles. This is semi-membranosus. Semi-membranosus. This is part of hamstrings. This is so important muscle. And another one is this one, this is popliteus. Popliteus. This muscle is important for posterior lateral connection. Semimembranosus is important for medial posterior part. Let's get started with semimembranosus. Okay, semimembranosus. It attaches on medial and posterior part of knee. Main part attaches on tibia, right? Then it flexes knee joint. However, semimembranosus has so many attachments. Let's say like this part, this is ligament, this is oblique popliteal ligament. Oblique popliteal ligament. And it also attaches to fascia of popliteus. Fascia of popliteus. Plus, semimembranosus goes deep to this yellow structure. This represents medial collateral ligament, also known as MCL. MCL. It doesn't have attachment with MCL. However, semimembranosus goes deep to MCL. So MCL and semimembranosus have very close relationship. Okay? Tibia, oblique popliteal ligament, fascia of popliteus, and semimembranosus has relationship with MCL. Look at these guys. These guys are very important structures, right? Let's say MCL. This is very important stabilizer for medial part of knee. Tibia, of course, yeah. And fascia of popliteus. Oblique popliteal ligament. This is connective tissue. What happens if semimembranosus gets tight? Or somebody ruptures semimembranosus? That can aggravate all these structures, right? Then let's go to a little bit more advanced. If you follow connection of semimembranosus and oblique popliteal ligament, runs like this way. Now it has relationship with this structure, right? Because there's connection. What is this ligament? This is arcuate popliteal ligament. Arcuate popliteal ligament. This one. Let's review from semimembranosus. Semimembranosus, oblique popliteal ligament, then arcuate popliteal ligament. By the way, arcuate popliteal ligament has relationship with popliteus. I will talk this relationship later. So it has like N kind of shape relationship, zigzag shape, right? Semimembranosus, what happens if this part gets tight? It can affect oblique popliteal ligament, then arcuate popliteal ligament. This connection is very, very important. If you know this relationship, you can apply for many things, right? Like a posterior part of knee pain, posterior part knee dysfunction, you know, these kind of things. That's why semimembranosus is not only for knee movement, but is also important for this fascial connection. Now, let's go to popliteus. Again, popliteus is this muscle. Do you remember? semi-membranosus has attachment with fascia of popliteus. Okay? Then, popliteus runs like this. Do you remember this ligament? This is arcuate popliteal ligament, right? Arcuate popliteal ligament. Popliteus passes deep to this ligament and attaches on femur. Okay? Then, popliteus also has attachment on lateral meniscus. Meniscus. This is also important, correct? Because function of lateral meniscus. Meniscus is shock absorbing system, correct? Oh, by the way, semimembranosus also has attachment on medial meniscus. I almost forgot that. Popliteus attaches on lateral meniscus. Semimembranosus attaches on medial meniscus. Now you see how important these guys are, correct? If semimembranosus gets tight, if popliteus gets tight, these guys can affect meniscus. Meniscus is so important for knee function, correct? Oh my gosh, I can't emphasize enough. These two muscles are freaking important. Now, popliteus goes posterior to arcuate popliteal ligament. And one more ligament. That's this one. This is lateral collateral ligament, also known as LCL. LCL. Do you remember? Semimembranosus goes deep to MCL. Popliteus goes deep to what? LCL. How many tissues did I mention today? Many, many tissues, right? I keep repeat again. Semimembranosus, important for medial, posterior part of knee. Popliteus is important for lateral and posterior part of knee joint. I just love this area because either one of them gets tight, that can have huge effect for posterior part of knee. In this video, I explained two muscles which have very big influences for posterior part of knee. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.